You're listening to the Wedding Biz Network, the voice of the creative entrepreneur.
Come on, y'all!
Hey everyone, it's Andy Kushner, host of The Wedding Biz, and this is another episode of The Next Level, in which I have a guest co-host, and together we talk about the interview of the week in a way such that you could bring your own business to the next level. And before I introduce today's guest co-host, I want to mention last week's interview was with stationer Lisa Zachary of Papered Wonders, and I had the wonderful planner designer Lauren Dickens on The Next Level. Both of those were very special conversations. I urge you to listen to them. And now today's guest host is Kurt Macher, GM of the Shangri-La Hotel at the Shard in London. Welcome, Kurt.
Hi, Andy. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, very welcome. And I really appreciate you coming on. I am just so impressed. Of course, before doing this, I had already heard of the Shangri-La Hotel, of course, but I went onto the website to see the London location. And oh my God, it just absolutely stunning. I would love to visit someday.
Thank you. Anytime.
Yeah. So the guest interview who we're speaking about this week is Richard EAGLETON, CEO of McQueens Flowers, an internationally renowned luxury floral design brand and flower school with customers throughout the world. They provided flowers for Vanity Fair's Oscars after parties for the last 25 years and was the floral design partner for the All England Lawn Tennis Club's Wimbledon Champions Ball and the London Evening Standard Theatre Awards. McQueens also provides floral arrangements for some of the most renowned London hotels. So, Kurt, it was really interesting. I hadn't heard a floral designer talk about the role of flowers in the way that Richard did when he said that they are ultimately restorative and helps provide preventive health care. How did you feel about that? What did you think?
Yeah, especially during these times, you know, everyone wants to have a lot of happiness and good feelings in their life. And I think fun, creative flower installations can create that for our guests.
Yeah, yeah. It is interesting. Ever since he said that, when I see some beautiful flowers, of course, I always am moved by them. But now I think back to the interview and it really is relaxing. And yeah, you mentioned especially now the stress we're all feeling. And, you know, he talked about how post-COVID mental health and well-being will be so important. I'm sure you agree with that.
Definitely. You know, and also for our team, when they come to the hotel and we changed over the hotel into those amazing installations, we've worked a lot on escapism inspiration and themed experiences last year because so many customers from the UK couldn't travel abroad. So we wanted to bring them destinations to the hotel. And not only did we bring through those installations happiness to our guests, but also to the teams because they come to the hotel and their surroundings affect their daily life as well.
That's a wonderful point. Yeah, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. You know, Richard also talked about how he views resolving the inherent battle between the creative and the business aspect of any company. You know, it's something that I like to ask all the guests because it really is an issue. I have a music and entertainment company myself, and it's always been a struggle to balance the creative and the business aspect of it. How do you at Shangri-La, especially as the GM, how do you view integrating the two?
It's a very good point. You know, to me, creativity in this industry and current climate is very important. And I think more than ever do we need to think outside of the box. You need to have great partners such as McQueens Flowers, of course, to help you to achieve that. And you know, I draw, for example, inspiration from fashion, travel, and art, not just only from other stuff. And Richard and his team have been actually very flexible. You need good partners who understand your end goal. You know, of course, everyone now has to save more costs to recover the shortfalls of business. And they have been extremely helpful in coming up with new ways of saving costs. But we're doing now bigger installation, but we don't do installations anymore every 2 weeks, something new. So now we do like a huge installation that lasts for a couple of months, where we spend more money, but at the long run, we save actually more money because we don't change over the decor every 1 to 2 weeks. So they've been great.
Yeah, that's interesting. You know, also, you know, I talked, as I have been with a lot of my guests since the pandemic started a year ago. Hard to believe that it's been a year. But I asked Richard, as you know, about how he handled it, how he's still handling it. How is he getting through the challenges of the pandemic? How is he leading his business through the challenges of the pandemic? And I love the phrase that he said when he said, never let a crisis go to waste. And of course, you heard the interview. He discussed how with a smaller team, temporarily, they basically reinvented their business model. I'm curious what you think of how Richard responded to that. And also, Kurt, how it is that you and your own team have dealt with just the extreme challenges of this pandemic.
This challenge of this epidemic definitely taught us a lot of lessons, but it also gave us an opportunity because we here in London, we have been during 3 lockdowns. But it means the hotel is closed, but it gave me and my team an opportunity to sit back and really think about new ways of doing business and how we can be more creative and what new offerings can we provide to our customers when we reopen. This has been really successful for us, and we had one of the most successful reopenings last year because we had the time to really think it through and come up with so many creative ways in offerings and experiences. For example, we had escapism, inspiration, multi-sensory experiences last year, which have been a huge hit by our UK customers. Then we came up with an idea of dining in the sky, where we're taking out beds out of guest rooms and we transformed them into private dining rooms because customers now are more comfortable in private spaces having dinner experiences. And all those things we wouldn't have done if we wouldn't have had the time to think about it and use this crisis to our benefit.
Oh my gosh, that's absolutely brilliant. Do you think that you will continue some of that after COVID is over?
Yes, for sure. And we will, take more time, come up with maybe less ideas, but more impactful ideas. But those make them really big and wow factors.
Yes, it's interesting. When it first hit me, and again, being in the music and entertainment business, live events, my business, and I have a business partner, it just absolutely was decimated for a long period of time. And we're starting to finally talk to clients again, and it's exciting to do that. But yeah, the slowdown for me also enabled my business partner and I to really sit down and think, not only what can we do now, but this, why not look at this, like Richard said, never let a crisis go to waste. We also looked at perhaps the opportunity that this might set up post-COVID. And so, I believe, most of us have had to, some of us even, reinvent ourselves, if not have some kind of pivot and add more services. And hearing what Richard said about how, again, they rebuilt the operations and structure of their business and how they expanded their online business did sound like he took advantage of an opportunity.
Yes, and to add on, we also focused on online opportunities. We're doing more retail as well, something we've never done before, but that also we learned that from the crisis and how to overcome it.
I want to be sure you know the wonderful news of our latest show, Stop and Smell the Roses, with acclaimed lifestyle and event design expert, Preston Bailey. Not only will he share the secrets, tools, and technologies behind his extraordinary ability to create a theatrical environment out of any space, you will also discover more about the man behind the magic. Preston will reveal how his focus on personal growth has been the root of his professional success, and you'll have the opportunity for him to answer your questions along the way. Plus, Preston will be inviting onto the show many of the star celebrities he has worked with in the past, so you don't want to miss a single episode. We also have another great show on the Wedding Biz Network, The Business of Being Creative, with host Sean Lowe. Since debuting last May, his show has really taken off, and he's continuing to bring you the creative business advice he's shared with accomplished industry notables. Be sure to take advantage of Sean's talkback opportunity by recording questions and comments from right there in each episode's show notes. So, if you are a creative who is turning your craft into a business or want to take it to another level, head to theweddingbiznetwork.com and take a listen to Stop and Smell the Roses with Preston Bailey and The Business of Being Creative with Sean Lowe. That's theweddingbiznetwork.com. I would also like to know, Kurt, how do you feel the event industry will be changed overall post-COVID? Do you have any thoughts about that?
Yes, I think this experience really taught us that people, really sensing a longing of being together again, coming together as a community. I think so many families haven't seen each other. I think there will be a spike of family reunions. We see that there's still so many weddings going ahead and they might be shorter now because of government restrictions. And also, we at the hotel and as a Shangri-La group, we really focus on our, we call it Shangri-La Cares, on our cleanliness standards and safety and hygiene standards that I don't think will go away anytime soon. I also think that technology will play a big part in future events. I think immersive experiences will be huge. Virtual experiences, hyper events will be a big new factor where, you know, other events, other companies can join in and join this one event because they can't travel maybe now, and how we can use technology in regards of track and trace. And you know, if they've done a COVID test already, is it on their phone before they join the event? So I think things will change for the future. But I think as well, the other point I want to make is everyone wants to have happy, fun, lighthearted events, more color, more themes. I think that's going to be a big trend.
Yeah. You know, I first want to respond to what you said about the technology. I feel that, and I've seen many articles about it, that this pandemic really helped the entire world to skip forward many years in terms of where we would eventually be with technology. You know, and I appreciate how, you know, again, I of course, I would not wish the pandemic on any of us, but since it did happen, you know, there are wonderful advances that we've made that we would otherwise have gotten 2 years later. So, and then you mentioned, I love how you mentioned not just the happiness, but more family reunions, how you feel there's going to be more of that. You know, it's interesting. I know, especially the first few months of the pandemic when we really were in shock and didn't know what was going on, and we weren't yet ready to figure out a whole lot about business. I did, you know, I started taking a lot of walks, and, you know, in terms of meaningful experiences, meaningful connections, you know, it just was so heightened. And you know, bringing it back to what Richard said toward the end of the interview, you know, he was talking about remembering why we do what we do, you know, and bring something of our story to it, which I believe is a part of what you're talking about now.
Yes, for sure. I mean, I think storytelling will be a key themed events, and how we can bring all those things to life in space, event spaces and hotels to create those great fun experiences for customers that they're longing to or have missed for so long.
Yes, yes. And also, you know, with what Richard said at the end, you know, he's hoping to bring more kindness as well as remembering why we're doing these things, you know, for a bit more humility and humanity. And I was touched by that. I love that idea. And you had touched on that too a little bit earlier when you mentioned that, you know, the importance of meaning and more happiness.
Yes, you know, I mean, our ethos at the Shangri-La Group and our hotel is like service from the heart. So that really comes through. And I think, you know, we as hoteliers, we need to make sure that our team delivers that service with a lot of kindness and friendliness. And I think that the stuffy service is going out the window. I think everyone wants to have lighthearted and very happy service. And, you know, we want to treat every customer like a family member. I think that will go a long way.
Oh, I absolutely love what you're saying. Well, that is all we have time for today. I want to thank everybody for listening. Be sure to check out the website of Shangri-La in London. And that website is shangri-la.com/London. I'll say that again, shangri-la.com/London. Social media handles are Shangri-La London. All of this can be found in the show notes at theweddingbiz.com. And also check out the information for Richard Eagleton with McQueens Flowers. And their website is mcqueens.co.uk. Also, McQueensFlowers.com. That is the United States site. The UK site, again, McQueens.co.uk. And their social media handles on Instagram and Facebook is McQueens Flowers. And I want to mention that next week's episode is going to be with Bentley Meeker, a major, major New York City-based contemporary artist and lighting designer. Very fascinating conversation about lighting and its importance to all of us in our lives. And so once again, thank you, Kurt. I really appreciate you helping me today.
It's my pleasure, Andrew. Thank you so much.
Thank you.